Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1652, a percentage chart from 100 tiny squares. Hey, I just got back from the MVP Summit, and during one of the presentations, one of the Excel project managers, Sam Radhikas, showed this really cool presentation, and one of the things that caught my eye was this series of charts that he was showing. So you see as the percentages down here along the bottom change, the percentage of the chart that's filled changes. This is kind of like a different take on the thermometer chart, but it was eye-catching. Now some people are going to argue, hey, wait a second, you're wasting 120 cells just to show a single number. But on this dashboard, it looked good. So I liked it. I asked Sam's permission to show you all how to do it. And he said, of course. So here's what we do. We take a start with a regular blank spreadsheet, choose 10 rows by 10 columns, so 100 cells, and I'm going to fill that with a nice light color. So we'll choose a light yellow here. All right, and then we have to add a border to all of these cells. So I'm going to press Control 1, and on the border tab, color, I'm going to choose white as the color, and then automatic and inside. It's really important that you put the border. While Sam was talking, I tried to build my own chart, and without the border, it really just doesn't look that good. Okay, now, down here in the lower left corner, we're going to put 1%, and then a formula of equal that cell plus 1%, and we'll copy that across. All right, so that gets us the numbers from 1 to 10%, and then equal the 1% plus 0.1, which increments us up 10%, and I'll be able to copy that throughout the whole range. Okay, so now we have those numbers from 1 to 100%. Good. I'm going to actually end up hiding those numbers later, but for right now, we'll leave them there so we can see how it's working. I'm going to select that range. Actually, we need to have the indicator. So this would be some sort of a formula down here that shows the percentage. I'm just going to use equal ran between 1, 100 divided by 100. All right, so that gets us our percentage. Let's format it as a percentage. And I'm going to do something that I tell you never to do. I'm going to use Control 1, and I'm going to reluctantly merge cells. I tried this with center across selection, and it just doesn't work as well. So, there we go. Change the font color to white, and we'll make it larger. There we go. Okay, so now that's actually sitting in cell B13. We're going to select this whole range of cells. We're going to go into conditional formatting. So Alt-O-D for conditional formatting. We're going to create a new rule. Use a formula to determine which cells to format. Now, this is amazingly simple. B3 is the first cell here, so we're going to say equal B3. No dollar signs there. Less than or equal to B13. And we want dollar signs there. And what we're going to do is change the format to something much darker. So if I originally used this light yellow, we'll go to the dark yellow, click OK, and that's all that it takes. So we're saying, hey, if this current value is less than or equal to B13, make it be dark. So right now we have 83%. The first 83 boxes will turn dark yellow. Click OK. All right, so now from here, we're almost done. I'm going to use Control 1. And on the number tab, custom number format of 3 semicolons. That will hide the numbers. We don't have to see the numbers. And then currently, the rows are 20 pixels. So I'll make this one be 20 pixels. Looking in the tooltip there. And that is 2.14. So we'll select that entire range, OCW, Alt-OCW. 2.14, click OK, so that way we have something that looks a little bit square, and now every time I press the F9 key, it updates, and we get the result. If you'd like, you can put a title up here, like I called this Manufacturing Line 1, and again, used some formatting there to make that look like a single block, so we could fill white font larger, and then merge cells again. Actually, this one, since we're not going to be changing this one, let's not merge these cells, and we will use horizontal center across selection. Click Okay, so there you go. Press F9, 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 F9. Very interesting looking, you know, for a dashboard to kind of show progress, and you can even stack them up, repeating the process to create multiple in a row. Well, my thanks to Sam Rad for that great trick, and check it out next time you're trying to create a dashboard. Use this interesting little, I'm going to call it a percentage chart. All right, well, I want to thank Sam for that trick. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.